The efforts of the training have paid off handsomely with the success of the national team on the 1984 World Cup circuit. At season's end, Canadians had won 47% of the medals awarded in World Cup competition. For the second year in a row, the men's combined event world champion was a Canadian. In 1983, it was Peter Judge. And in 1984, the men's crown went to Alain Laroche. These results speak well for the programs run by the Canadian Ski Association. Freestyle competition is the aerials. The spectacular and often dangerous looking jumps are always popular with spectators and score well with the judges. This event has probably undergone the most change since its early days with the single flips introduced by Stein Erickson, now being replaced by triple twisting maneuvers. Today's competitors have to be strong athletes and possess a great deal of coordination, dedication and skill, as well as courage. Although the jumps look difficult, the repetitive practice of them has removed much of the danger. To prepare for this event, the competitors will spend much of the summer on water and hay jumps perfecting their flips. The reason that the sport has advanced so much is directly attributed to the increased off-season and off-snow training. Mike Nemisvary of Great Britain shows us how he trains for competition.
For myself, I've been bouncing on the trampoline as long as I've been freestyle skiing aerial-wise, if not longer. I've been at it for about 8 or 10 years now. Trampoline is a definitely important part of the whole training for aerial acrobatics because it gives you an awareness in the air, gives you a sense of balance, it gives you the flexibility that you need. It's pretty well the key to doing aerial acrobatics. I don't think there's one competitor out there jumping that hasn't been on a trampoline and been very proficient at it. So that's one step. There are a lot of divers as well. I think just putting it all together, little diving, little gymnastics, a lot of trampolining, and then you go to a water ramp. So you have to have this progression. People who think they can just go out there and throw a double back or triple back or asking for injury, and there are a few that will do that, but it's very controlled, very precise. To be able to do an aerial maneuver like that, you have to have had a lot of gymnastics background, a lot of trampoline training. But I have the potential to place right up there in all events. Personally speaking, I think, if I work at it, it's going to come sometimes slow, but it's just a matter of perseverance. I do like the ballet and I do like moguls. That's my bread and butter is combined. I'm just in it to be the best out of all three events. Some people are contradictory to that thinking. They say there's not enough time. If you want to be the best, you have to be the best and work at just one event. I say that's wrong. I want to be the best combined out of ballet, moguls, and aerials, and that's my goal, is to work towards being combined world champion.
How successful the training has been is evident on the judges' scorecards. Besides the form they show, their confidence approaching the jump and their landing all attribute to the score. explain what they are looking for in the aerial event is World Cup judge Brian Pittman.
In the aerial event, it is judged differently than the belly event in that we do multiply the three judges' scores by a degree of difficulty, which is determined by the judges' subcommittee in the of the FIS Council. And the degree of difficulty, for example, a back layout is lesser degree of difficulty than a triple back somersault. And new jumps come every year in freestyle. Every year there's brand new jumps because the competitors' competition is getting so much better. At the FIS Council meetings, they look at the new jump and they compare it to the other ones and add on increments accordingly.
Skiing has gone through a healthy development stage. With the help of the Canadian Ski Association and other interested groups, the future looks very promising. We hope that this program has sparked some interest for those of you who may want to try freestyle. But if you're just content to watch the events, hopefully you'll get a better appreciation of the sport and those involved with it. I'm Laura Lee Bowie.